So we'll continue the module 5, Agentic Digital Switching System Model. Hardware architecture. The hardware architecture of a hypothetical digital switch is as shown in the figure. It is based on quasi-distributed control architecture. The architecture of a DSS is very complex with many subsystems. It consists of following main modules. We can see the diagram here, switching fabric. So that is denoted by SB and network control processor NCP1 and network control processor NCP2 up to network control processor NCPN is connected to switching fabric. So we see the explanation. Central processor. It is a primary processor in the digital switching system and it is always duplicated. The function of central processor is to provide system-wide control of the switching system. It supports secondary processor as network control processors. The CPU control the high-level functions of the switch and supports operation, administration and maintenance function, that is OA and M. The CPU controls the system recovery process during critical faults. The CPU maintains subscribers and office data. It supports billing system for the switch. Network control processors, that is NCP. The NCPs are the secondary processors. They provide call processing functions and assist in setting up a path through the switching fabric. Many number of NCPs are present in the generic switch. They are usually duplicated and depend on the desired size of the class 5 central office. NCPs are interface with the interface controllers and provide medium level call processing support. NCPs are associated with particular ICs to keep track of all calls controlled by the ICs and associated path assigned for it. NCPs interfaces with other CPs or NCPs to update call paths on a regular basis for global view of all calls for other NCPs. Third one is interface controllers. Most of digital switching systems employ a processor-based controllers that acts as concentrators of all incoming lines or trunks. These concentrators use time multiplexed output to the NCPs and provide time switching functions. Interface modules. The interface modules used in the DSS are line modules, trunk modules, and special modules. Line module may terminate a single line or scores of lines. Most DSS use smart line cards that are processors driven. A smart line card performs basic call processing functions such as line scanning, digital collections, and call supervision. The trunk modules interface different types of trunks to the DSS. Most DSS employs special modules to connect integrated service digital network and other digital services such as advanced intelligent network and packet switching to the switch. Switch fabric. Most digital switching systems use at least one space or S switch. The connections in the ICs are time RT switches. The S switch is usually accessible to all NCPs. In some cases, the switch fabric is partitioned for the use of different NCPs. Software architecture. Generic switch software architecture is as shown in the figure. First main part is system level software for this, maintenance software, call processing software, database software. Call processing software is divided into two categories, that is controller software and network software. For controller software, peripheral softwares are connected. System level software. Most DSS employ the system level software. Software at this level is a multitasking operating system, is based on duplex mainframe computer. The function of the OS is to control each application system developed by the DSS. Basic software maintenance for the digital switch can be classified into maintenance software, call processing software, and database software. Maintenance software. The software industry spends almost 80% of its effort in maintaining software. Digital switch maintainability can be grouped into two categories. Supplier-initiated software maintenance. This consisting of software maintenance action needed to update or upgrade a generic release of a digital switch. These also include application of patches or software corrections required to correct faults in the existing generic release. Software maintenance by site owners. These are the routine maintenance action that must be performed by the owner of a digital switch to keep it operational. Example, additional of lines and trunks to the digital switch. Call processing software. Based on the architecture of DSS, the call processing program can be divided into three levels. High level functions, medium level functions and low level functions. High level functions. High level includes call processing functions that require support from a central processing unit. Examples are specialized billing, office data and translation data. Medium level functions are, these are referred to as a network software. These reside in the network processing units. This level includes call processing functions such as establishing a path through the switching fabric, verifying a subscriber, and maintaining a call map. These are called as network softwares. Low level functions. These are shared between the interface controllers and the line modules depending on the architecture of the DSS. These functions may be line scanning, digit collection attaching, service circuits or call supervision. Database software. Most DSS employ the database system to the record office information, system recovery parameters, system diagnostics and billing information. So recovery strategy. Recovery strategy of a digital switch is based on a three level schemes. These schemes depend 0-3 control levels. Level 1 initialization, level 2 initialization and level 3 initialization. Level 1 initialization, INIT1. This is the lowest level of initialization for a digital switch. This INIT1 recovery initializes all the components that functions at a level 1 control. It is controlled and directed by the IC, which control LMS, DMS and peripheral modules. This is called as local recovery. Since it can be initialized peripherals locally without impacting the operation of the entire DSS. Example, after a thunderstorm, a technician in digital CO found 17 LMS, 5 TMS and 2 PMs hung up non-operational. This is resulted in partial outage and operational difficulties. Then technician use INIT1 initialization for recovery. Level 2 initialization. This is the middle level initialization for all the components that function at level 2 control. This INIT2 recovery could be directed for initializing the specified NCPs or a group of NCPs. In this hypothetical DSS, distributed architecture is used. Here, NCPs controls the number of ICs and the ICs controls the LMS, TMS and PMS. If a duplex failure of a NCP pair occurs or if NCP breakdowns and backup NCP is not switched to active mode cleanly, then ICs connected to NCPs will be impacted. Then we use two types of recovery strategies are used. If the problem is due to the NCP switch from the active mode to standby mode and the switch is not clean, then IC runs INIT1 initialization online, trunks and peripherals. If that does not help, then INIT1 needs to be run to initialize the NCPs and associated LMS, DMS and PMS. If the problem is due to processor switching but to hard complex failure in the NCP pair, then INIT2 needs to be run immediately. This is normally impact all the connected ICs and associated LMS, DMS and PMS. Example, a technician tried to switch a NCP with its redundant side after the diagnostic for NCP failed, then technician can use INIT2 initialization to overcome these problems. Then now next one is level 3 initialization. This is the highest level of initialization for a digital switch. This level of initialization functions at level 3 control. This IN93 recovery could be directed for initializing the CP and NCPs. This level of initialization is run when the redundant CPs fail or the CP switch is not successful and the DSS cannot fully function with the defective CPS. Here, first recovery program identifies the problem in the last known good CP. It can work with reduced number of NCPs or NCP at all. After diagnosing the CP, then system will run INIT2 process to synchronize all NCPs and bring them up online. This level of initialization will cause a total system outage. Example, a DSA starts experiencing a slow dial tone even after initializing the INIT2. Then technician may use this INIT3. This solves the problem. This problem is mainly because of software corruption in the CP. Manual recovery. Manual recovery of the digital switch is used when repeated use of INIT3 does not recover the system. In manual recovery, the generic program with the last known good office data, selected subscribers data is located in the digital switch. The basic idea of manual recovery is as follows. Bring up the system with the manual effort. Since automatic runs of INIT1, INIT2 and INIT3 fail to bring the system back to online. The current generic program and the data may be corrupted. The system is updated with the last known good generic program and data. Then manual or specialized diagnostics programs are used to identify, recover the data.